Now, can I please take this opportunity, as this is our last afternoon show for Radio 2, I really, really do appreciate the outpouring of goodwill toward this program, and me and the team, Janie, Tim and Bobby. I'd like to say a huge thank you to everybody and anybody who's been involved in this program over the last 23 years. Hundreds of guests, contributors, producers, broadcast assistants, our brilliant Radio 2 staff in Wogan House, studio managers, the online department, news, sport, travel, and so many other wonderfully inspired people, including, of course, our lovely co-hosts here, Janie Lee Grace, Tim Smith and Bobby Pryor. To all of our stupendous guests that we've had on, our in-house comic voices, John Coleshaw, Lewis McLeod, to the music team and all the incredible production staff we've ever worked with. Most of all, personally, want to say thank you to you for your appreciation, our dearest listener, smashing and loyal, for all the reaction, all the nice words. Thank you if you've ever seen your way to listening to us over 23 years at any time. Thank you, thank you, and thank you again. Corny though it sounds, I quite like the way that we've all helped each other get through some of our ongoing problems together, the pandemic, the financial downturns, the ups and downs of life in the UK. Sometimes it's been very difficult for everybody. I've tried on this program to bring just a little bit of light relief, a good genuine atmosphere, uplifting tunes, good conversation, a little bit of satire. We tried to make the show unique and just be good company. I can only hope that we've done that some of the time. I'm also really aware there are more things to think about than a radio show ending, so I don't want to be too self-indulgent. What I do want to do is celebrate the show's success and long run, and also mention that I'm not retiring. I am not retiring. And we'll continue with love songs every Sunday, Serious Jockin, and some Christmas specials on Radio 2. There is a more in-depth message, as you may or may not know. Special message to you. If you look for Radio 2 on Twitter or Instagram, click on the link or look on the Radio 2 website, bbc.co.uk/radio2. Look for the Steve Wright in the Afternoon page and you'll see some lovely messages. And let the show continue now. So now it's down to this as we enter the last 15 minutes or so on Steve Wright in the Afternoon on Radio 2. Can I say I'm not retiring from radio and will continue with Serious Jockin on BBC Sounds and Radio 2's Love Song Show on Sundays. And we'll be all over the Radio 2 map in the coming weeks and months making documentaries, Christmas specials. I'm so glad today was a celebration of the success of the programme, and I want to say thank you again to everybody who's ever been involved with this programme. Guests, celebrities, stars, authors, politicians, experts. They've all come to Studio 6B and been brilliant. Most of all, I want to say thank you to you for listening from the bottom of my heart. If you've listened at any time over the past 23 years, me and the team don't really quite know how to thank you enough. And it goes without saying that I love you. And we've shed a few tears over the past few weeks. Let me just do a few personals, if I may, to great friends and mentors. Patrick and Inge, Richard Easter, Mark Wells, my good friend and talented journalist Justine Green, Dr. Hilary Jones, the best medic and contributor I know. Shout out to Lisa for her high humour. Thanks to Jim Moyer, legendary TV man and former controller of Radio 2, who gave me the gig on Radio 2. And, well, let me get on with it. With the phrase, whatever you do, righty, don't frighten the horses. All right, Jim. And Paul Rogers, genius radio producer, who was my first producer at Radio 2, an inspired producer, creative force, a good mate, and an excellent wine expert. And thank you to you, Gary, out there. Thank you again. And also thanks to Anthony, also through the glass right now. Then there's the hundreds of people I know in radio and comedy and news and journalism, pop stars, TV people, film industry, actors, writers, you name it, they've been on. So thank you, and I'm sure we'll work together again. Big up and thank you to all the people on the other radio stations, BBC and commercial, We've still got a great radio industry going on. And a little cheeky tribute that I saw today was one radio station who put my name on a bridge. So thanks, guys. Good one. This is Radio 2. These are the closing moments of Steve Wright in the afternoon on Radio 2. In the spirit of celebration and fun, let me ask Janie Lee Grace about her favourite moments working on the programme.
Well, I remember the first time I met you, Steve. I don't know if you recall, but we were at a party at the Café de Paris.
I do.
It was an album launch, but I'd heard that you were starting a show on Radio 2, and I bounced over and cheekily told you that I was a really big fan and you should hire me as a co-presenter. And lo and behold, you did. And it's unbelievable to realise how long it's been. I only really know how long it's been because I had one baby when I started, and then three more were born on over the 23 years, and we've had just so much fun over these years. It's a bit embarrassing because it shouldn't be called work, should it, really? I remember once we had a chat on air about what would we do if we won the lottery, and I said I would do exactly the same thing, and I really, really meant that.
And Tim Smith.
It was great working with Janie and Bobby and people like The Old Woman and Ask Elvis and Barry from Watford and many other contributors and talents. So thank you, Steve, for the opportunity to have done so much, learn a lot, and do a job that I thoroughly enjoyed. Thanks also to Radio 2 for the other opportunities I was able to undertake on the network. Thanks to all the many producers, assistant producers, guest bookers, interns, and studio managers who we've worked with over the years. They've been a brilliant and professional team, and trust me, without them, I don't think I'd have sounded half as good as I hopefully did. And thanks also, of course, to the listener for all the kind words and comments over the years, and for staying with us. Because if that hadn't happened, we'd have disappeared a long time ago. But hey, we've had a great run. I've had a great run. Wouldn't have swapped it for the world. And here's to the future.
And Bobby Pryor.
It's absolutely no doubt I've got the best job in the world on this show. It's just so lovely to be part of. And one of the things I really loved was when we took the big show to the big show with the biggest arts festival in the world, the Edinburgh Fringe. Steve is a great showman on the air. He's also a great showman on the stage, and you don't see that very often, so that's really brilliant for us. A massive highlight for me at that Fringe that year was I'm a massive fan of the Australian team, the Doug Anthony All-Stars. They reformed that year and came back to the Fringe, and I was so excited, and it was so lovely that Tim and I went to see the show, and it was just a magic moment to be able to do that.
I'm going to see you Sunday and every Sunday for Love Songs and for all the many other programmes in the coming weeks and months. On behalf of the team, this has been Steve Wright in the Afternoon. Remember the old closer?
Steve Wright in the Afternoon on Radio 2 from the BBC.
All material is copyright.